Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. And in today's video, I'm going to make you show how to set up n8n MCP server. An MCP server that can do everything end to end, that can help you create a new workflow, edit the current ones, and manage everything in your n8n server. Let's get started. Now, as you can see on this place in Claude, I've given it a very simple example. Use an n8n MCP server to create a new workflow to trigger an AI agent. Whenever a new Google Sheet row is added, just simply trigger an AI agent to generate a YouTube script. And I'm going to press hit enter and see what comes up. Let's see from there. Now, very simply, the n8n server is connected. It's going to go ahead and figure out the options. So it goes and runs the diagnostics, searches for the nodes, and then in a couple of seconds, and I'm going to tell you everything on how you're going to set this up. So don't worry, like, you can just stay with till the end of the video, so how you can actually go ahead and create this. Okay, and now it's finally running the create workflow tool, and in a second or so it should have a workflow completely new in my n8n, which literally did not exist before and is, like, you know, again, mostly 99% done. As you can see, it has already created one. The name of the workflow is YouTube script generator, and if I bring you back to my n8n, as you can see, there is nothing here, right? And I'm going to refresh this, and in a second we are going to see a new workflow which did not exist before here completely exist, and you have YouTube script generator Google Sheets trigger. If I can tell you that this is the most coolest moment right now, I'm pretty sure you will agree. Again, I wanted to give it a very simple prompt so that it can connect it quickly and I don't spend, like, again, it takes sometimes 5-6 minutes to create some of these workflows. But very simply, I can put in the Google Sheet ID. Obviously, I can connect with my credentials and everything else, whatever I want to do, and, like, you know, run this. I can, like, simply connect this to a chat model and, like, you know, sort this out. So if I connect it to, like, an Anthropic chat model, it will be automatically sorted. Same way, I can connect it to a Google Sheets trigger here by creating a new credential. Once I do that and bring that back again, all of these things are just possible because of one simple thing, that is, like, you know, an n8n MCP server created by a great developer which is existing here. Now, again, if you like the demo itself, like, and just, like, you know, hold on for another 5 minutes, you will be able to do it yourself. And it can do a lot more. It can also tell, like, you know, if I go to this MCP server and I can tell you, like, you know, some other things, like, for example, tell me all the workflows that exist on my environment in n8n, right? And it will automatically go ahead and also search the workflows and can do that. Okay, we are existed, like, you know, the length limit for this, and we can start a new conversation and do that. So if I just go ahead, start a new conversation and press this, it will go ahead and now search my environment. You can do a lot more. This is a very simple example of what kind of a server you can create, what kind of a workflow you can create, but here is how to set it up. Let's get started. Number one thing is you need to come to this particular GitHub repository, which is created by this amazing person. I am sorry, I can't pronounce his name, but CZ, and we're just going to call him CZ right now here. Again, and, like, you know, he has an amazing video also on how to get it started. Go ahead and check that out. But this particular repository, right, only thing that you need to do to run this is very simply go to this link. This link will be available in the description. Go ahead and do that. And then step number one, you need to see if you have Node.js installed. If you don't know how to install Node.js, it's super simple. Quite literally, click on get Node.js and just select Windows and just start installing. You don't need to worry about anything else, right? Again, so if you're not coming from a programming background, please just click on this. Takes a couple of steps and you're done. Okay, so don't even worry about it. And you can just simply download from a Windows installer or a binary, and whichever works. It's super simple. Takes 5 minutes, install it. Once it is installed, the only thing you want to do is go to command line, right? And you're going to copy and paste a single command. Okay, let me just show you the command. The command exists here is npx n8n mcp. You can see this simple, quite literally, this is the command here available. The command will be available in the description also. So in case you don't want to come here, just go ahead and do that. Like, copy this, paste, and I'm just going to paste anyway, and it can, okay, I'm just going to, like, you know, npx paste anyway, it pastes with this, and I can just press enter and it will start running a server. It will automatically start running a server. It takes a couple of seconds. I already have one running. If you're running it for the first time, it might take a minute. Just wait for it. It will run. Don't even worry about it. It works perfectly. And you have an n8n server completely done. But you're still not done. There is one more step on how to give Claude access. So as you can see, it's, like, still going ahead and doing my stuff. To give Claude access, and if you don't know what Claude is, I'm pretty sure you know now if you're following me for some time. And if you're not, please go ahead and try. Go ahead and subscribe to me. It really helps me out a lot. This is Claude, right? And you have to go to Claude desktop. You want to install this download Claude. You want to download this, right? So just download it for Windows or Mac OS, whatever you are on. And once you've downloaded this, you will come to a screen like this, right? You know, that's pretty much it. Once you come here, you're going to, okay, let me just maximize. You're going to come to File on the left-hand side. Okay, so left-hand side corner, click on Settings. And in Settings, you're going to come to Developer, right? And in Developer, you will click on this part. You see Local MCP Servers, and you're going to click on Edit Config. Okay, now once you click on Edit Config, it's going to bring you to a file, a JSON file. Don't worry about it, okay? I'm going to walk you through here also. You're going to come to a JSON file, and I'm just going to open it very simply. And once you are here, what you need to do is you need to go ahead and copy this part. So you can see this is the full configuration part, right? You need to copy this particular path, right? So this is everything that you need to copy, okay? Now, the point is, you see there is a small caveat here. You need to input your URL and you need to input your API key. Now, if you are on n8n.io, right, you technically can't use it to edit and do all of those things. You need to self-host your n8n either locally or online. Now, how to self-host? I have a complete video on this, which is attached here. Go ahead and watch it on how to host it. So if you host it, you guys can see I have a different, like, you know, completely different URL here, which I've hidden to somewhat, obviously, but it's hosted on EasyPanel. But again, I have a separate URL here, which allows me to run my n8n on cloud, right? And once I have it on cloud, I can give it access using my Claude code environment. So this is the URL that we're trying to copy and paste, okay? So you copy this URL, you're going to paste it instead of this. So instead of this, you're going to paste it here. And then for your API key, for the n8n API key, you're going to click on this. You're going to click on your three dots here on the left corner in the below when you, where your name is written. Click on Settings. I'm just going to leave this without saving. And come back here and select on n8n API, right? And then just click on creating an API key. That's it. That's pretty much super simple. Once you click on create an API key, you can name it and it will give you a key. I'm just going to write test YT and click on this and it will now give me an API key. Obviously, I've hidden that for obvious reasons, but you can copy and paste this key in the same point. So once you are done with all of this, you will see your cursor file to have an API key here, right? Which I can just, like, you know, simply just to show you guys, I can do something like this, right? You can just say API key, whatever you have copied here, right? You will put that here. And then very simply, another part would be the URL here, which will be like your URL. Now, it could be anything that you have copied and pasted from your server once you have hosted it. If it is on localhost and if you're hosting locally, it will just be localhost 3000 or whatever port you are hosting it at. But once you have done that, that's pretty much it. Once you're done, only thing you need to do is switch off your Claude code and open Claude again. And once you open Claude again, and I keep saying Claude code because I've started using it recently, but you just open Claude again and you will see this running, and that's pretty much it. In case it does not show up, just restart Claude once more time and you will be good. And quite literally, you are done. You have a Claude environment which technically allows you to simply run an instance and manage everything from your Claude desktop, right? So you can go ahead, create a new chart, and in there you'll see this n8n MCP tool available. You can see all the tools that it has access to, right? Everything that it has access to, you can obviously disable all of them if you don't need them. You can enable all of them. You can only choose some of them. Whatever works for you, you can use this to do that. Now, if you want more information on how to use this, this person, this amazing person, which I hope I was able to pronounce his name, has also created an amazing prompt which you can use. They have a whole Claude project setup available here. Okay, so go ahead and you can copy and paste this into the prompt in Sonnet and, like, you can just start working on it, right? So again, it works beautifully. It has the prompt and everything else, and you can use it as you want. Now, the only thing is, this is probably the last thing that we need in the whole n8n workflow because it allows you to get started much faster. I've been using it for quite some time and I'm seeing just that, like, you know, the quality of response and the kind of content I've been able to get from, like, creating is, like, my starting point has become so much faster because now I just go into Claude, tell it I want this, and it goes ahead and creates that in n8n. And I'm happy, n8n is happy, everyone is happy, and we get done faster. Now, one small thing before I end the video, I don't, like, you know, again, if you are ever using this video again, please give this repository, which will be linked down below, proper credits. And if you see someone else telling you, like, you know, you need to put down in comments in somewhere and, like, you know, engagement farm you, please don't do that, right? This person has done an extremely amazing job giving it all away for free. Let's just respect that everyone else should also get access to this for free. And, like, you know, that's just a call to action to anyone who loves And if you love this video and if you liked how I explained this, please like, share, and subscribe. It really helps me out a lot in creating more videos like this, and also allows me to, like, you know, figure out what you guys actually like. Please go ahead and do that, and I'd love to see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.